Welcome. I'm Jillian Kiefer, Pharmacy Technology Chair, Clinical Coordinator, and Assistant Professor. In this video, you will learn how to calculate a total parenteral nutrition, or TPN, solution, which is the most common compounded nutrition solution. There are three PDFs that can be downloaded so that you can follow along and do your own calculations throughout the video. For the best learning experience, download and print out those documents prior to watching this video. A TPN is generally comprised of a highly concentrated dextrose and water solution, which may be mixed with amino acids, fat emulsions, electrolytes, vitamins, and minerals. All TPN solutions provide a 24-hour supply of all nutrients needed for survival and must be prepared using sterile components and a strict aseptic technique. There are many factors that go into prescribing a TPN, such as a patient's age, diagnosis, bodily functions, the flow rate at which the patient will receive the solution, the volume required for the 24-hour supply, and the medications the pharmacy has in stock. For the purpose of this video, we are going to work off a TPN order and do the calculations of the required medications based on what the pharmacy has. This is the TPN order where it tells us some patient information, gives us the flow rate per hour, and the medication and strengths the doctor would like. I have broken down into a table to show a little better of what the doctor ordered versus what the pharmacy has in stock. With this table, we can now do calculations to know how much of our in-stock ingredients are needed. The first calculation is to find the total actual volume based on the flow rate provided in the order. Since we know the flow rate, we can use the ratio and proportion method to find the total amount of milliliters needed in a 24-hour period. We set up the proportion by placing the flow rate of 10 milliliters over 1 hour on the left side of the equation and the unknown milliliters over 24 hours on the right side of the equation. You must make sure the units match before cross-multiplying. Cross-multiply, then divide and solve for X. X equals 240 milliliters, which is the total actual volume of the TPN solution for this order. Next, we move on to the bases of the solution, dextrose and amino acids. According to the order, we want dextrose 17.5%, but we have 70%. When you have a percentage, that is the number of grams per 100 milliliters. So the dextrose 17.5% would look like this when set up for a calculation. 17.5 grams over 100 milliliters. To calculate the number of grams of dextrose 17.5% needed for the total volume based on the order, you would set up another ratio and proportion calculation. On the left side, you would have 17.5 grams over 100 milliliters. On the right side, you would have your unknown number of grams over 240 milliliters. Cross multiply and divide to solve for X. X would equal 42 grams, which is the total amount of grams needed of dextrose 17.5%, but in stock we have dextrose 70%. We must now calculate how many milliliters of the 70% solution is required to get the required concentration. We know we have on the left side of the equation 70 grams over 100 milliliters because our dextrose is 70%. We need to calculate the number of milliliters of the 70% solution to total the 42 grams required for the order. So on the right, we have 42 grams over the unknown milliliters. Once we cross multiply and solve for the unknown, we have 60 milliliters of the dextrose 70% solution that will be used in this order. There is a secondary way to calculate this for the bases. You can use the total actual volume multiplied by the desired percentage. This is the wanted percentage based on the order, and divide that by the in-stock percentage, what the pharmacy has on hand. This is a different formula you can use. Use whichever makes the most sense to you. If we did it the second way for the dextrose, we would have 240 milliliters multiplied by 17.5, and then we would divide that by 70. This would total the amount of 60 milliliters required for the prescription. I will now show you how to calculate an additive as it is a very similar process. This will allow you to work through the rest of the calculations yourself. The first additive is sodium chloride. The order wants 18 milliequivalents per liter. The pharmacy has in stock only 4 milliequivalents per 1 milliliter. With the order basing the additives on liter components, We must get that down to milliliters, as this is what the pharmacy uses. We need to know that 1 liter is equal to 1,000 milliliters, as we will use milliliters in our equations. To calculate the number of milliequivalents of sodium chloride needed for the total volume based on the order, you would set up another ratio and proportion calculation. On the left side, you would have 18 milliequivalents over 1,000 milliliters. On the right side, you would have your unknown number of milliequivalents over 240 milliliters. Cross-multiply and divide to solve for X. X would equal 4.32 milliequivalent, which is the total amount of milliequivalents needed of sodium chloride. We must now calculate how many milliliters of the in-stock sodium chloride is needed to get the required concentration. We need to calculate the number of milliliters of our 4 milliequivalent stock to total the 4.32 milliequivalents required for the order. So on the left, we have 4 milliequivalents over 1 milliliter. On the right, we have 4.32 milliequivalents over unknown milliliters. Once we cross multiply and solve for the unknown, we have 1.08 milliliters of sodium chloride. 4 milliequivalent over 1 ml is what will be used in this order. There is a secondary way to calculate this for the additives as well. You can use the total actual volume multiplied by the desired milliequivalents, wanted based on the order, and divide that by the in-stock milliequivalents, which is what the pharmacy has on hand. This is a different formula you can use. Use whichever makes most sense to you. The only difference is because the order is based on liters and what the pharmacy has in stock is based on milliliters, there will be one extra step at the end. If we did it the second way for the sodium chloride, we would have 240 milliliters multiplied by 18 milliequivalents, and then we would divide that by 4 milliequivalents. This would total the amount of 1,080. That needs to be divided by 1,000 due to the order being based on 18 milliequivalents per liter, and the final answer must be in milliliters. Once you take 1,080 divided by 1,000, you would get 1.08 milliliters required to fulfill the order. I have now shown you a base calculation and an additive calculation. Now pause the video and try the rest for yourself to see if you get the correct answers. Then resume the video to see the correct answers. Here are the correct answers. Once you have all the base and additives calculated, you must remember to consider the syringe size you will be using when you draw these up, as you will have to round some of the answers to accommodate that. Once you have the rounded answers, you will need to calculate that total. With this calculation, you will see your total volume is only 140 milliliters with the bases and additives. A TPN is meant to also have sterile water added for hydration, and this is how you calculate the total amount of water required for the order. Total actual volume minus the total amount of bases and additives together, and the answer is the amount of water required to complete the TPN. For this order, 240 milliliters minus 140 milliliters equals 100 milliliters of water will be added to the TPN bag after all bases and additives are added to give the total actual volume 240 milliliters. It's a good idea to make up scenarios and practice these calculations on your own. To learn more, look for our other videos on pharmaceutical processes and techniques.